Stickpeople concert is amazing. My first one was my 7th grade year, and this will be, I think, my 5th one. And it's just, it's a lot of fun. It's exciting to be able to, you know, be out there under the lights and have everyone watch you. It's just, it's amazing.
It's a concert that everybody should come. Stickpeople is a concert everybody should come. It's really fun. It's enjoyable for the kids, and it makes the kids want to do music. It will help with the music program grow in our schools.
The Stickpeople concerts, funnest thing I've ever been a part of. You go out on stage and you have fun, the lights are on you, you tell the people staring at you, and you feel like you're the spotlight. It's something that I've once in a lifetime experience.
Ginger's awesome. She is a great teacher, and she's really involved in just everything she does, and really lucky to have her.
She also does a great job just teaching kids about basically what percussion is and how to be a percussionist. So she's really pretty extraordinary in what she does and how she helps people. So
Ginger's really nice. She's a really nice lady. I've been taking lessons from her for about 4 years now, and I've enjoyed every second of it.
First Stickpeople I did, I remember I carried everything over there myself to the hall, and I was marking the floor and doing all this stuff. The second year I had a couple parents say, "What, can we help you do something?" I'm like, "Well, yeah." So it's just kind of grown from there, and now we have a whole production crew of parents that have volunteered to help. The reason I started Stickpeople in the first place was to give the students an opportunity to perform. So I got to thinking that I needed to do something so that the students could show the parents that they're doing something, and the parents can see that their investment and their money is doing something good. So I put together, it started on a small scale the first time, but it's grown a little bit.
I'm at the school right now, so maybe I'll touch base with you when you get here. In the past, I've done the floor organization, organizing the floor, getting everybody's drums in place and whatnot, and this year I'll be doing some of that, and also be helping up on the stage during the production itself, you know, how they move marimbas in and out the floor and drum sets, moving things around, and just kind of whatever Ginger needs, I'm here. I'll take off work Wednesday, Thursday, Friday to help her get things going.
This year, the concert I've been started ahead of time, helping them get some barrels rounded up for drums, just coming to support them, just being here to listen to them. And if Ginger has questions or little errands that she needs ran, I'll help out with that. Just whatever I can do.
What else? Are we getting down to the panic stage, or do I not have to panic just yet? Yeah. The parents of my students are great. I have been just, I couldn't ask for better, really better kids or parents, and they're so supportive. Okay, the role of the parent, if you have a child taking any kind of a music lesson, which I'll focus this on music, that you need to have a parent support. You need to have them say, okay, this is going to take time.
And I got Monster Bubbles.
I got two monster bubble machines.
You forgot the machines.
That are so
cool.
The ones
that we had the other day?
Yeah.
The Kansas Rhythm and Jazz Ensemble came together from an idea that I had where I wanted to have some sort of a percussion ensemble experience for my students outside of the public school experience.
The Kansas Rhythm and Jazz Ensemble is just a group of people who've taken lessons with Ginger. I think it usually ranges from middle school to high school, about seniors, and we just get together and play different types of percussion ensembles just to show a variety of what we can do.
There's a lot more that can be learned from being in a percussion ensemble. You have a lot of different instrument techniques that you can experiment with. There's mallet instruments and shakers and all kinds of cymbals and timpani and bass drums and pipes and all kinds of things that make sound.
I am practicing for the 6th grade drum line.
And Stickpeople is just amazing because she takes drummers that are just getting started, that have only played for a few months, and she adds them into the mix with drummers that have been playing for years and sometimes even decades, and she gets them all together as equals and they can all play at the same time. So it's a neat experience for all of them.
I've been able to start some students at age 5 or 6 and stay with that student until they graduate high school and sometimes junior college. And so it's like a family. It's teacher-student, but to watch the student grow and mature both as a person and musically is a real treat for me.
First things we need to do Wednesday are get in there, set the floor, get that other end, and if you're going to be down there taking care of that, that'd be great.
You got the little green papers, Miss?
Yes. I mean, Lord.
Do you think we have enough?
I think so.
Program's ready to go to the printer. The Big Kid Ensemble is coming together, sort of. I did get the drawings done for the floor plan for the Rhythm and Jazz Ensemble. I think I messed up.
You need to go to number 7.
I do need to go to number 7. You even knew that. Okay, here we go.
12, 9, 7.
This is Jada's first year to do Stickpeople. Last year she wasn't quite ready for it, so she's very excited, and yes, very much, very excited about going and doing a Stickpeople concert.
Best friends, magic in me, playing on the drums all day, beat it. This is the first time I'm playing.
Ginger's awesome. awesome. Jada frequently has a poor attention span. She tends to move from every few minutes to a different conversation. And Ginger's wonderful. She's used different media to pull Jada's attention back in there.
This is the floor plan for Stickpeople. And each little paper is a different player. I'll be sitting there, and then the top row is all my seniors. The green dots are kids that get to do, that want to do double pedal solos. The green tickets here are some of my big kids coming back. Two of my alumni, and then one older kid that sits out here where the young ones are. So that kind of helps keep the time. Everything's numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so forth. So each item is a certain thing in the show. And so you can see I have a senior solo here and a senior solo here. And so we have a few items already coming in that will be raffled off. Last year we gave away a couple drum sets and a double pedal and some cymbals. And so they're really neat prizes.
What do you mean, let's go in order?
Go in order of what we need to fix.
Oh. Yeah.
Measure 56 is
the first
one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Whoa!
Brazil. The floor plan is close. Are we good for Wednesday, 8 o'clock here with the trucks? Do we have people?
Well, see, we could. Our drum stands, because last year I remember we had a drum sitting on a chair.
Yeah, Brent says he's borrowing Brittany's drum set this year.
Okay.
It's pack-up day. It's load-in day, so it's in high gear. Pack-up, load-up. Everything in here has to go. Thank goodness I have help. So fortunately, the father of one of my students has access to a great big huge box truck. I don't know what you call it. But he's been very awesome to help us out, and even fix the truck up so he can put in some shelving so you can stack stuff. And yeah, he'll back right up to the door, and we'll just start carrying out.
Well, we're loading out everything from Ginger's drum school into the truck, and it'll go down to the convention hall, and we'll reset.
Usually the people that are helping out in the, with all the setup and stuff, usually they pretty much live there for the 3 days.
The production crew is a group of several students and parents and some of Ginger's friends that organize Stickpeople and put it all together, and it takes a lot of work, and Ginger couldn't do it by herself. On Wednesday, everyone will bring in their drum sets, and we have to set the floor and the risers, and on several other days they'll be messing around with audio and light equipment, and we just have to make sure that everything's going to run smoothly.
Marking the floor.
We taped all the windows to make it dark because Jenny wanted all the windows taped off. Now we're getting, I call it opening the floodgates, because at 4 o'clock all of the kids are getting off school and all the drum sets are coming in, so we're helping everybody move their drum sets in and get them all set up. And they've been working on the lighting and the music today.
You see this the first time through that you think there's no way it's ever going to come together. But then at the end, it does come together every year. Somehow it's like a miracle.
You excited? Yeah. This is Ryder's first sticky.
Talk into the camera.
Say hi.
Thank you.
one thing, this was the first time in a few weeks that we've had all of the ensemble members together because of various conflicts with school commitments that they have when we have rehearsal. It's just there's so many things going on and these kids want to do this so much that they don't want to not do it. But it's hard to make it work because they're committed and they have school events and they have family events and, you know, they want to do this. But my thing is that I want them to do it, but I'm not going to let them do it badly. I mean, the stuff that I expect them to do is really advanced material. And I mean, my thing is that I know these kids have the potential to do that. I can see that. And I give it to them knowing that I know they can do it. It's just time and commitment and, you know, focus. So usually they come through. Yesterday was the short circuits because we've never been able to play it and hear the accompaniment at the same time because in my studio I don't have that facility for them to hear. We're always too loud. So that went together fairly well yesterday, surprisingly. They came up with the idea of the mask because we were trying to figure out what to do from basically the waist up. We have the sticks are wrapped with the glow in the dark tape, but that leaves, you know, a kind of a gray area. So they came up with that on their own, put the masks, and it'll look cool. I'm excited about that.
Spiritual thing. All right?
It's once you start, you just go. And the rhythms are interacting. You have to, one depends on the other. There's a fundamental rhythm that goes through the whole thing, and it builds and builds and builds. It probably went as well as it could yesterday for the first time. Everything sounds different in the hall than it does in the studio or what. But we got in all the drum sets except for one. One came in this morning and I think that makes 59. I think we're gonna have 60. Kids are supposed to show up by 4 o'clock, so I imagine after 3-ish, 3:30, everything will start to get a little crazy. We will have a sound check tomorrow. I want to have a 4:30 or 4:15, get busy with the sound check, run our opening, run our closing, and get run through. We don't have time to run the whole show tomorrow, so we have to be really on top of it. All right, now, here's the thing. This group over here needs to go up there. You know how to get there? All right, you guys follow them. This group over here needs to go up there.
First balcony. Oh, you guys are going way top. See, I think we should go in the way top, you guys. Yeah. You'll have more fun. All right, so let's try this. I want you all to be very quiet. And then as soon as bang on the drum starts, you can start coming down, clapping hands.
Thank you.
stop 1 second. All right, everybody, I wrote this with the rest in there for a reason. You're supposed to not play in the rest. Please not play in the rest. I know it's exciting to be here and all that hoo-ha, but just do the song like it's supposed to be done and don't overplay, okay? Everybody sounds really good, but don't overplay. Okay, we can start music whenever.
Hi, my name is Bob, and I approve this message.
If I put the show together like they do a musical, everything has a number, it goes in order, and it's very organized. So each song, each event has a number. Each song has a number. And then I've scoped it out most of the music. We'll be applause here, and then we'll get set and go.
You might need a
watch me get lost, okay? 1, 3, 4, 1.
Thank you.
So sometimes it's a small miracle if this comes together, because we haven't had everybody together in one place to rehearse all of this stuff yet. This will be the first time we all get together, and we have one chance at a rehearsal, and that's today. An important thing for the kids, so the parents are very supportive of that, because they see their kids get motivated and get excited, and it's worth it to them, I guess, and they love being around the action and the activity, seeing all this stuff.
But that first cymbal crash starts off, there's a big crescendo, so you can hit, but then, you know, build up and then back off. So make it musical too. We're not just banging the drum, except on the first song that says bang the drum. I have to prove to people that we are musicians so we can keep music in the schools, okay? All right, so here we go.
Mama, life in charge begun. The love coming. Easy go, will you let me go?
Cymbals. So while they're doing that, you can get those ready to do that, okay? Thank you. Chaotic this year, because in the middle of my dress rehearsal there's about 15 or 20 students that have to leave and go perform another concert at their middle school. So we're going to try to crunch everything and get it at least run once before they have to leave, and then we'll run the other stuff that doesn't involve them so much after.
Here we go. Now, if you have your little hat thing or whatever you're going to do, put it on. Oh yeah. Okay. All right. Here we go.
Now,
Here we go. If we're ready, anytime. Guys?
Thank you.
bow. Applause, 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 applause.
There were a couple postings on Facebook this morning from some of the kids. They're like, woohoo, you know, stick people. And it's like, yeah, it's here.